Most fine chemical manufacturing processes today employ a technique known as batch processing. This technique uses a reactor or reactors of a fixed size that the chemicals are added into. When the reaction is complete, the chemicals are removed and the product is isolated. One can think of batch processing as cooking pasta. You use a pot of a fixed size and you can only put as much pasta in there as will fit in the pot of boiling water. In contrast, an alternative manufacturing technique is called continuous flow processing. While this technology has not seen widespread adoption in the chemical or pharmaceutical industry, the petrochemical industry has made use of continuous flow for decades. You typically use a continuous flow device to which the chemicals are added continuously and the product chemicals are removed continuously. Continuous flow requires the reaction to operate under fast reaction kinetics, and one can think of continuous flow processing is like a commercial pizza oven where the uncooked pizza goes in one end and the cooked pizza comes out the other end. Continuous flow technology offers many compelling advantages and opportunities as compared to batch chemistry. Continuous flow requires a significantly smaller footprint to operate. This smaller footprint can turn into lower operating costs as well as lower capital expenditures for its construction. One major limitation to batch chemistry is the variability observed from batch to batch. Due to the fundamental principles of continuous flow, batch-to-batch variability is simply not an issue. In addition, continuous flow enables organizations to access highly reactive or unstable intermediates, as well as operate at more extreme temperatures and pressures. This creates a competitive advantage for organizations using continuous flow. Finally, taking a process from R&D to commercial manufacturing is often faster and easier, typically involving numbering up as opposed to scaling up, thereby avoiding many of the common scale-up issues. Finally, due to the reality that only a subset of reagents are in the device at any one time, the risk of catastrophic accident is greatly reduced.